nanoHUB-U, online instruction.
Hey everyone, welcome to lecture 312. So we're continuing with MEEP, and now we're going to talk about how to simulate a different system, which is the ring resonator. So you can think of a ring resonator kind of like the index guided waveguides that we had before. And remember, we added a bend. So you can think about it like you're adding a very soft bend multiple times until basically a straight waveguide gets bent into a circle. And what's interesting about that is, in addition to being able to guide potentially like a broad range of frequencies, there are certain boundary conditions associated with the circular nature of the waveguide. And so then, especially if it's a small ring, then that means that the spacing between the modes is actually pretty wide. And that's induced by the need for fields to be unique as you go around the loop, right? So you basically have to pick up a phase that's a multiple of 2 pi as you go around. And so, like I mentioned, the free spectral range, which is basically a measure of the distance between adjacent modes in frequency space, varies inversely with the ring radius. So then a large ring can have lots of modes, small ring only a few. And then another point that's even more important and non-trivial is the losses. And so if the ring is small, you can imagine, based on the sharp bend that we had earlier, that it can create lots of losses. But what's not necessarily as obvious is that if it's a bigger ring, so even though it's bent gently enough so that you don't break the index guiding condition, and so the radius of losses go down. In fact, they go down exponentially as you increase that radius. So here's some code that just illustrates how to set up. This, of course, is the same as before for the index of the waveguide, but then you also have this new parameter, the inner radius of the ring, and some padding parameters that basically just give you some space between the ring and the perfectly matched layers here, DPML of size. And so then that allows us to set the size in the X and Y directions, which we put into a 2D lattice. And then we create two cylinders, in fact, one with a high index that has a larger radius, which is equal to the inner radius plus the width. And then we create a second cylinder, which has a radius R, which is made out of air. And that basically takes the initial cylinder, punches an air hole through it, so then that creates a ring structure, or more precisely, an annular structure. And then you set up the PMO. And then here we're actually setting up the pulse to excite the source. And you can see actually from DF being 0.1, Fsen equal to 0.15, that means it's a very broadband pulse. And we make it out of a Gaussian source, and it's centered close to the inner edge of the ring. Okay, so at R plus 0.1. And then we run the whole system for 300 time steps beyond the end of the sources. We output the epsilon, and then we output the EZ field. And so that'll actually give us a good idea of what kind of modes are being produced by the system. And so if you want to actually try this in the comfort of your own computer, then you can actually go to this website, nanohub.org/tools/MEEP, and you can actually run MEEP yourself. And there's actually this example already built in, and so it has a lot of the code already there, and you can run it. One thing you can try changing actually is the radius of the ring. In this particular example, the default is 1, but you can see it's up here. It's like one of the early parameters. You can change it to whatever you want. You can also change the refractive index, see how those affect the performance. In the next lecture, we'll talk more details about what you get from the ring resonators and performance.